Hi, in this video, we're going to be talking about using pitch in Doubler 2. So to start with, let's take a look at the pitch wheel in the play tab. So the wheel gives you feedback on the pitch you're singing and the corresponding note that's being sent out to your door. The spokes that fan around the wheel light up in a coral color according to your input pitch and the envelope, and they act like a compass pointing towards the note your input singing is closest to. This is also a great way to see if you're singing flat or sharp. On the outer circle of the pitch wheel, there are evenly spaced segments showing the active notes in the key we have set. So the current key we have set restricts the output to that specific range of notes in that key and will help avoid any unwanted notes. So if you want to find out more about how key restrictions work, make sure to check out our other video that goes in depth with the key tab. But for this video, I'm just going to stick to the C major scale. So one of the most important things when using pitch in Doubler is remembering to be clear and confident with your input style. The difference between mumbling a melody and singing it clearly and confidently is quite drastic in terms of the MIDI output you get. So let's show you a quick example of that in Ableton. So in Ableton, I've got a basic electric piano set up, and what I'll do is I'll sing a simple melody in two different styles and show you the resulting MIDI information. So let's start with a simple three-note melody, and I'm going to hum this one, and it's going to be slightly quieter and mumbly. So there I just sung. But if we take a look at the MIDI information, we have notes in between all of those notes I was trying to hit. And if we listen back, it's not quite really what I wanted. So now if I want to sing those three notes, I'm now going to be a lot more confident with my input style. And as a tip for me, I'm going to use a percussive input sound at the beginning, such as a da sound, da, 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 so I can really make sure those notes are distinct. Da, da, da. So if I take a look at that MIDI information, we have just those three notes and nothing in between. If we listen to that back, there's no other additional MIDI information like we had with the first one. So remember to be clear, confident, and distinct with the notes that you're singing in. So let's take a look at some of the settings in the play tab that we can adjust whilst using pitch. Doubler detects the octave of the note you're singing, and if you want to adjust the octave of the output, you can do so in the bottom right here. For example, I could lower the output to a minus one, and that means I could stay singing at a range I'm comfortable in, but the output could then be used for bass lines or something else. On the left-hand side, we also have the option to turn pitch bend on or off here. So pitch bend allows you to bend the pitch of a note with your voice, the same as you would with a pitch wheel on a MIDI keyboard. So pitch bend works over a range, where the range number represents how many notes away from the original note you can bend. So for example, with a pitch bend range of 2, if we start singing a C and bend our voice up, then we can bend 2 steps as far as a D before a new note is triggered in our door. The really important thing here is to make sure the pitch bend value in Doubler matches the pitch bend range on the MIDI instrument or plugin in your door. If these numbers don't match, then the output pitch in your door won't match the input pitch of your voice. So let's give an example of how that sounds with a pitch bend range of 2 and show you how now I can bend in between those two notes. There are different types of pitch bend we can choose in Doubler 2 as well, so let's head over to the Assign tab where we can change this. In the bottom left, whilst we have pitch bend on, we can choose between IntelliBend or TrueBend from this drop-down menu here. So IntelliBend is what's on by default, and it's what we heard in the example before. It's an intelligent system that turns off pitch bend when you are settled on a note. So you can bend into or out of a note, but whilst you are close to a note, you'll be anchored to it. How strongly you are anchored to sustain notes can be adjusted using the stickiness slider in the play tab here. So true bend here will give a more precise bending based on your input and will track your voice more closely than IntelliBend. We can also set the pitch bend range here the same as you would in the play tab, and we can also apply pitch bend to chords. So pitch bend can be applied to chords separate to the root notes that we're singing. So whilst this is off, let's go back to the play tab and turn the chords on here. So here, as I sing this example, the root note I'm singing will bend with my voice, but the overlapping chords will play as normal. If I go back to the Assign tab and now apply pitch bend to the chords as well, you'll hear that the chords now bend with my voice as well as the root note. So also here we can see sliders in the top right for sensitivity and stickiness. So the sliders can be adjusted to improve Doubler's response depending on your input style. We recommend keeping these at default level whilst you're first getting used to Doubler, but they can be adjusted to find what fits best for you. So pitch stickiness on the right here determines how close you have to get to another note before the MIDI information will change. So a high pitch stickiness will make it easier to hold a note, but also harder to change from it. The sensitivity slider allows for more accurate control depending on singing or input style. A higher sensitivity level will pick up more information from your voice and would be recommended for quiet singing or humming, but higher sensitivity levels can be more susceptible to background noise, and so a lower level might be preferable for louder singing styles with noisy backgrounds. So that's a brief overview of using pitch in Dubbler 2. If you want to find out more, including going in depth with chords and key restrictions, make sure to check out our other videos on our Learn Dubbler page.